So it made that, that focus and that filter that we had in place, made it a lot easier to pick the pieces that we put together.
Can I show the wrong thing?
Let's show it.
And then talk about it after.
Yeah.
Yes, I can, suddenly, yes, I can. Gee, I'm afraid to go on as 22. Yes, I can. Take a look, what do you see? 133 pounds of confidence me. Got the feeling I can do anything. Yes, I can. There's something that sings in my heart is telling me. Yes, I can. 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 Yes, I can.
Hey, yes, I can.
No. You can't.
Yes, I can!
Are you ready? I can climb Everest. Yes, I can. I can find your own mountain Everest. Yes, I can. I was just born to be. I can go all the way. Yes,
this piece of film has everything you could put into a piece of film and answers so many of the questions that we ask ourselves about how we push our industry forward. It's bold, it's proud, it has diversity, it has gender equality, it is craft, it is originality. It makes us feel things that we, as I said, the range of emotion, it makes us happy, makes us think. I think it's extremely provocative. And I think the most important thing, and we all discussed this for about maybe 2 seconds, is that it pushes humanity forward. And I think that's the thing that we both, we most focused on when we chose this. And I think more importantly, it has that one element that I think great film, great storytelling has, and it has that tension, there's that antagonist and there's that protagonist in it. And when you look at that all combined, if you were to be given that brief, that put all of those things into a piece of film, I don't know if you thought about it, you would be able to do it. That's why we think it's a superb example of a solution to a brief that you could possibly come to.
Great, we'll take questions afterwards, but let's first hear from Kai, who was, of course, the president of our titanium and integrated jewelry.
Thank you. Thank you. I think, first of all, I want to thank also my incredible jury members here sitting in the front row. One of the finest, best juries I've ever judged with, actually. So thank you very much. The interesting thing is that titanium and integrated has been separated, which actually is a really wonderful thing. So well done. So let's talk about the integrated first, shall we?
Yep.
Now, the integrated, the jury and I, we sat down and really discussed about what integration really means. And I think we hit the right buttons when we found an answer. And the answer is not about intermediate. It's not about something that, you know, we go from radio to out of home to a piece of content into long form and short form film. We felt very strongly that true integration, new integration, is about transcending intermediate and integrating into culture and society. And I think that really needs to be understood. So what we awarded from there points to that direction. And the Grand Prix is an incredible piece of work. And also, I would have to say that our jury, for the first time, I think we made history, because it's equally, you know, there's an equal amount of women and men on the jury, which is a feat actually in itself. 50% were women, 50% were men. And that really gave us deep conversations. So we became really forensic in our conversations. And what was awarded is actually proof of that conversation, which is very much needed today. So,
shall we show the integrated? The integrated was pretty first.
This is the true story of how a prepaid wireless company confronted a horrible truth within the American election system.
One thing that most people don't understand is that the elections are controlled at a county level, not at a state or a federal level. So each county has different jurisdiction over the rules and regulations for how voting happens in that county. We reached out to every county in the United States with a boost door, which turned out to be 817 counties in 48 states.
We thought that a lot of counties would appreciate the offer, but we were surprised to find that we actually had a lot of resistance.
The team began wondering why they were facing so much resistance from certain counties. Why wouldn't officials want to make voting as easy as possible?
Making it difficult to vote at every stage of the process has been a strategy to suppress part of the electorate.
There is a game that is played where the polling places are manipulated in order to suppress voter access.
And what they're really doing is they're suppressing the vote, not preventing fraud and making more accurate elections.
When we started this program, we thought that it was lack of resources. As we went through the process, I really believe that this is a systemic problem.
The team realized they were working within a system that in some cases intentionally makes it harder for people to vote. They began wondering if their solution was feasible, but then a breakthrough.
After 7 months working on it, there were 30 people, hundreds of phone calls, didn't look like it was going to happen, and then we got our first start, and then we got another, and then another.
Ultimately, the problems that plague U.S. elections can be fixed, but it's up to the American public to hold our election officials accountable and demand equal voting access for all.
Voting has to be a fundamental right, no matter who the people are.
We'll take questions later, shall we?
Yes.
I think we all know what the titanium is. I think a work that is disruptive, irreverent, and breaks the mold. And we felt this piece of work is so incredible that it really deserves the Titanium Grand Prix. We also wanted to award what the world loved. So here it is.
And the problem is this. Women are not making it to the top of any profession anywhere in the world.
This thing has got the permanence of it. And the zeitgeist is ready, the culture is ready to accept that and embrace that. It's about time we stand up for women in a big way. And hang on, not just for women. It's for fighting against fear. Especially in the world today where it's ridden with fear everywhere, disruption, fear the business, fear marketeers and clients, and this really stands in the face of that. So we love that wholeheartedly, and it's a unanimous decision by the jury. Incredible piece of work. Actually, when I first saw that piece of work in New York, it was just mind-blowing, because it just changes your perception. And that bull has been there for so long. And then you put something against that. So there's great tension, and we love that.